And my seven-month-old dog won't take no for an answer when another dog doesn't want to play with her. She'll chase and bark at them nonstop.
That's up to you.
Trainer says to redirect, but that doesn't
work. Fuck that, redirect. Jesus fucking Christ, are you serious? Other trainer says to fucking redirect. What are you, nuts?
My God. Zero to 100. Real quick.
I have redirect turrets. Tourette's.
Redirection. My God, you have a heart attack.
Next.
I can't even finish the freaking sentence. You didn't answer.
That was one run-on word, too. Sorry, I failed school. I never learned what a comma was.
You didn't answer it.
What's the question? Ask the question again.
The dog chases and barks at other dogs.
Okay.
To play.
Oh, so redirect
it. Back off.
Hold up a bone. Redirect it. Here you go, dog. Chase this instead. Next.
What the hell?
Correct it. So remote collar, no, correct. Actually, if it was in a social situation in our socialization yard, we use a stockyard whip, believe it or not, walk up to it, whoosh, it's a little smack on the butt. Next. Going live. Now we're live. And we are live. How's the lighting? There we go. Ah, now we get lighting.
Is this the color I like?
Is this the color you like? I don't know, but you decide real quick while I'm doing my intro. Hey, everybody. How are you? It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. This is the What Would Jeff Do show. How is everybody? It is Saturday night. Saturday night is, I don't know. What day? Today's the 15th, maybe. Did you find the show? There you go. You got it. Do you like the color? Is the color okay? Does your hair look okay? Okay, fine. Thank you. I'm glad. So you started the show? Great.
Sure.
We got a board and train facility up in Providence, Rhode Island. We actually do more than board and train, but we specialize in aggression rehab, behavior modification, a lot of fear, anxiety, a lot of human and dog aggression, a lot of leash reactivity. But we actually have a brand new puppy program as well. We actually had another puppy class yesterday. Saturday, this morning. Yes, we did our pack walk again this morning. So we do a lot of stuff. We're real dog trainers. What I mean by that, real dog trainers, we actually rehab dogs. We actually stop unwanted behaviors. We're not just teaching basic obedience. We're working with some of the most difficult, challenging dogs that are out there, dogs that are not only just physically badly behaved, but mentally not all that put together really, really well. That's important to note. My seminar series, I'm doing 25 cities around the world this year. It's a two-day seminar. Those are problem-solving seminars. And then this podcast is pretty much a problem-solving podcast. So on my seminars and on my podcast, what we do a lot of is we help you stop unwanted behaviors. In order to stop an unwanted behavior, you're going to hear me say the word punishment a lot. The reason is because that's actually how you stop an unwanted behavior. You cannot stop an unwanted behavior with a reward. It will not work. It can't be done. That will only get you more of something. It will not get you less of something. So you're being lied to. You're being lied to. We also talk about training equipment a lot. Okay. Shock collars, remote collars, call it the same thing if you want to. It is the same thing, by the way. So prong collars, bonkers, all of these things that are wonderful to not only to train, but also to apply a punisher to a dog. All right. We concentrate a lot on state of mind as well. That doesn't mean we're shutting down dogs. We are stopping unwanted behaviors. A lot of misinformation out there. The internet is full of lies. Your vet is full of lies. Trainers are filled with lies. We are giving you the blunt, honest truth about everything. Nothing I suggest is anything that I have not done hundreds, if not thousands of times successfully. Next.
I haven't even started.
Let's start the questions.
Jessica, got my Mexican food. I'm here early. I'm ready for some entertainment and to learn things.
Awesome. Why don't you just put a little bit of a post up on Instagram stories, Mexican tag us, food. And we'll share that. Next.
Magic Larry, good evening and hoping all is well with you folks.
Yeah, things are great. Things are fantastic. What do we got next?
Unique. Does it start at 5 or a different time?
8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. A couple minutes late tonight because everybody's out of the house except for myself and Angelo. Linda is out. The kids are all out. And so I had to put Angelo to bed at 8 o'clock, has to be at 8 o'clock. So 7:59 was too early. So I had to wait till 8, and then I had to come down here to do the show. So we're a couple minutes late today. Here we go.
Scandalisa. Oh, I haven't seen you on here in a while. How to get my German Shepherd to be interested in a freaking tennis ball?
Actually, I don't know. That's not the training that I do. I think, you know, I'm fortunate that my personal dogs have got ball drive. That's not one of the things we train with. We don't train with toys at the training center. What I would do is just try a tug, try a Kong. It might not just like tennis balls. But I'm sure some of the sport dog community has some videos out there to help you out. But that's actually not what we do. So it's not my level of expertise. Next.
Unique. Oh, yep. How to stop my dog from peeing on my pregnant roommate?
First of all, how does that possibly happen? Walk me through that. Actually, don't walk me through it. So whatever is happening, don't let it happen. So all I know is if your pregnant roommate, number one, is a human and the dog is an animal, therefore it's a different species, and the animal walks up to the dog, to the human, and it even appears that it's going to piss all over your roommate, all I know about this is I would let that dog know in a life-changing one-second remote collar shock that that is a really, really bad idea. And that's how you stop it. Next.
Don, how do I get my one-year-old golden doodle to walk away from a situation versus growl or bite?
So that's I just put up a video from the Elkhart, Indiana seminar on my Facebook page and Instagram page, and it's probably up on YouTube right now. I'm not sure what it's titled, but it's about a dog literally being trained to walk away. I do a narrative, and then I show it in real time with an actual dog who struggles with the exact same situation. Next.
Melissa, good evening, Jeff and Joelle.
Hey, Melissa, how are you? Great to see you last night. Next.
Unique. Also, how to stop my dog from biting people when playing?
Okay. Number one, for now, this won't stop it, but don't let your dog play with other people. It can't make good choices. So that's triage. That's how you stop it. So to get your dog to stop doing that, it's more involved. But for now, if I owned a dog that was biting people while they were playing, why would I ever allow my dog? This won't fix the problem here, but let's just think rationally. Why would I ever let my dog play with anybody else until I figure this out? So number one, you have to teach the dog how not to do it to you. But you can't expect other people to do the teaching. But your dog is getting too aroused and making bad choices. So you have to set it up. You got to get your dog to do it to you. And then you would apply a punisher when the dog does it. But if my dog was doing that to other people, I wouldn't let other people play with my dog. Next.
Michelle, good evening. Jeff, Joelle, and Melissa.
Hey, how are you?
Judy says, where are you? Oh, that was at 8:05.
Couple minutes late, guys. Couple minutes late. Okay. Relax.
Keep the people waiting.
Okay. 3 free shows a week. Okay. Relax. Next.
Zebra. I have a dog who reacts when dogs that he doesn't know come in his face. How can I help him with this? When in the yard, I have him on place and he's okay when dogs pass and when we walk by dogs on leash.
Right. So what is the problem?
He reacts when dogs that he doesn't know come in his face.
So why? Okay, again, I would never, first of all, I should watch the video that I mentioned, but I wouldn't have unknown dogs walking in my dog's face. I have a different lifestyle with my dogs. I don't want an unknown dog walking up to my dog without incredible control. So if it was in my training center, we would set it up. And what I would do is I would make sure I understood that dog, the unknown dog, which would be now a known dog, and my dog. And we would role play it. And I would teach my dog to move away, and I would teach that dog to move away. But I would never allow an unknown dog to come up to my dog ever in a million years. Why? I don't trust them. That's why. I've seen it go bad so many times. So there are things, oh, so that doesn't help, Jeff. That didn't fix it. It's called preventive as well. And there's also, you have to make these decisions. In 2019, we have to train for 2019, where there are owners and dogs that are not, the owner is in denial about the dog's behavior. I know that owners are bringing dogs who have gotten into dog fights at dog parks back to the dog park. That'll let you know that owners aren't making the best decisions. So that's why no unknown dogs meet my dogs. Next. Hold on. We've got a $4.99 top chat. There's a $2 one too, but it didn't show up. I just saw it go by in the feed. I mean, we might want to just give them a quick shout out. That's it right there. From Marissa. Hey, Jeff, as a father of many children, do you have any advice for us to have our four dogs and one-year-old daughter to coexist safely? Yes. You've got four dogs and a one-year-old. The one-year-old is probably starting to walk right now. It's an unstable walk that makes dogs extremely nervous. Make sure you teach your child the word no, which means you don't approach the dogs. Teach the dogs place. All the dogs go lie down. Teach the child to coexist with the dog. The child doesn't need to pet the dogs. The child doesn't need to meet the dogs. The child needs to exist with the dogs. I wouldn't allow a one-year-old on hundreds of dogs. Hundreds of dogs. I just posted a picture today on Instagram and on Facebook of him swimming with two tops, my own dogs. But he's with them daily, all the time. The dogs are with my kids all the time, but they don't go up to them. They leave them alone. My kids leave my dogs alone. I want that big separation. You've got four dogs, one toddler. It could be a freaking death match. So never unsupervised. For one split second, not 1 second. I don't care if you have to shit your pants, you pick up a kid and you take it with you. I don't care. You never, ever, ever, ever. People assume, oh, well, of course I wouldn't. No. I'm talking not even for a split second. Next.
Rose Brothers Dog Trainings donated $2.
Got it.
How do I get more clients?
Okay. How do you get more clients? Follow what I do. Follow what I do. First of all, do a business Skype with me. So if you're a dog training company, invest in a business Skype with me. Okay. But for a simple question, put out massive amounts of free content with no obligation of anything in return. None. Don't keep track of likes. Don't keep track of followers. Don't care who watches your video. Get rid of any negative comments because this is a dictatorship, not a democracy. If you don't like my shit, get off my page. There's plenty of other pages that do. This isn't a discussion forum at all. Have that mentality when it comes to your social media. Put out massive amounts of stuff that helps people. Okay? Next.
Batman says, happy Father's Day, Jeff.
Thank you so much.
Scattered storm would stick around, but my Wi-Fi has been unreliable lately.
I understand. Watch the replay next.
Judy Schwartz says, great to be with you.
Great. Thanks, Judy. How are you?
Head to tail dog training. How to teach an extremely stubborn 16-pound dog down command. Currently no food drive to lure. Will not succumb to prong pressure. Yelp stands up. Never worked with such stubbornness just for down.
Okay. What I want you to do is anything possible. Anything possible. You might have to wait the dog out with leash pressure. Wait the dog out with leash pressure. Only use the food that it eats for training. Don't let it eat out of a bowl. Only use it for training. You're not starving the dog. The food's right here. You just have to do it down. Next. Top chat, David Solomon. How do I help my three-year-old shepherd husky become confident with other dogs after two traumatic dog fights? Any tips? Yes, existence. Have your dog around lots of dogs, but not interacting. The best thing in the world you can do. Have your dog around. This is like the third or fourth time I've talked about existence. Okay, socialization is not necessarily interacting. It's being around. Have your dog around lots of dogs. And then Rose Brothers Dog Training, how do I set up a Skype? Go to my website, Solid Canine Training. Solid Canine Training in the shopping cart. You can actually purchase one. I do so many Skypes, we actually made it easy for everybody. Then my office will schedule it with you. Next.
Caitlin, I plan on getting a golden retriever pup for my mom within the next year or later. Any tips on introducing a puppy to adult dogs who already live with us? I'll be training the puppy as soon as I get it.
Does your mom want the dog? Number one, does she actually want the dog? That's important. Is she going to take care of the dog? Does she actually want the dog? Make sure she wants a dog. Okay. As far as how to introduce, I need to know way more information about your current dog, what its behavior is. How does it do with puppies? I need to know what your skill set is. Can you recognize pre-dog fight warnings? Do you know how to advocate for the puppy and advocate for your dog? Again, existing. advocate for both dogs. Puppies should be spending 20 hours a day in a crate, not in a row, but split up. You also have to make sure that if the puppy is not pissing off the older dog, okay? If it does, it's going to correct it, but some dogs don't know how to correct properly. So there's a lot of variables. The biggest thing is they don't need to be best friends. They need to exist. A lot of older dogs don't like puppies. They become a major pain in the ass. They don't like the pressure of another dog always on them. Some dogs are great with it. I've owned great puppy raisers. I've got other dogs that aren't tolerant of puppies. Next.
Don, hi guys. If my dog's eating and I have the e-collar on and he growls, do I give him a correction? If yes, what do I do next? Take his food away, carry on with letting him eat. What if he's a scared? I don't know. It got cut off.
Okay. So first of all, what's the growl? I need context on growling. I'm not opposed to all growling. Most I am, but I need more context. What you do is this: feed your dog in the crate, put your dog in the crate, put the food down, come back 10 minutes later, take the food up. But if you walk towards the dog and the dog growls, you teach the out command. The dog will be corrected for growling around you. Absolutely. I don't stick my hand in food bowls. I teach dogs how to move away from food bowls with the out command, and I have videos on that. So what you're doing is you're telling the dog the presence of a human, you back away from the food bowl so you can safely pick it up. But I'm not going to stick my hand in a food bowl. Okay, next.
Top chat
from Joe. I have a crush on Joelle. I'm not a troll. I'm a 35-year-old divorce lawyer in Florida. I own my own practice. I'm 6'6", 250 pounds. So right off the bat there, just Joe, buddy, right off the bat, you're listing materialistic things. I'll give you a little clue here. When Joelle was 18, that would have impressed her. When she was 18, that would have impressed her. But what I know about Joelle now, that's not like the top 20 categories that she wants. Your height, your weight, you've got abs, you know, you go to the gym. You know, go to the gym is good. So start with go to the gym. So rework that, okay? If you want to give you $25 off, $25 back in, you can do a do-over. You want to do a do-over, I'll let you do a do-over. So take it, get rid of the 34-year-old divorce lawyer. You don't even need to, like, she's in the middle of a divorce. Okay, that's probably a trigger word for her. It's probably a trigger word for her, okay? She probably doesn't want to hear that. She's not impressed with the lawyer part, not impressed with the 6'6", not impressed with the 250, not impressed with the abs. Go to the gym, that's good, okay? Not on steroids, we're going to assume that you're not. So you didn't even have to mention that, okay? And then use the videos to train my labs. That's a good one. But rework it. Rework it. Do a do-over, okay? Next.
Amanda, I was walking past some neighbors doing yard work with a weed whacker. The leash was short, and he was walking in a heel. He freaked out, and I corrected with the prong. Was this correct?
Yes. Next.
Kyle, hi, guys. Six-month-old German Shepherd puppy. Fine in his crate for a few hours, but if I'm gone, say 4 hours, he starts trying to escape. I've watched him on a camera I've installed. Nothing I can do whilst it's happening.
So what you do is try to, is the dog freaking out? Totally freaking out?
Trying to escape,
yeah. What you have to do is set the dog up with a remote collar. You've got to leave the house, video camera on the dog. Remote collars work up to half a mile away. Correct the dog for trying to break out. Also, what I want you to do is, if you were in another room in the house, will the dog also try to do it, or is it only when you leave? If it's only when you leave, you actually have to leave, and then you just set it up. Put the dog in another room, pretend you leave, or actually physically leave. Next.
Lucy Paul, happy Father's Day, Jeff.
Thank you so much.
Pam, scheduled Vegas in September. What do I do in the meantime? Dog is a whiny, reactive dog on walks, not aggressive, scanning always. Bonker makes him cower. E-collar makes him cower.
Well, what's the issue again? Why am I not listening? I'm watching the up front for some reason.
Well, pay attention.
Okay.
She's scheduled to come to Vegas in September.
Oh, good.
What does she do in the meantime? She has a whiny, reactive dog.
Okay.
Bonker makes him cower, and the e-collar makes him cower.
Well, I don't know how you're using the e-collar or the bonker. So yeah, I'm not sure how you're using all the tools. Remember, these are tools. You actually have to apply them a certain way. It's like you have all these paintbrushes and paints, but it might look like crap, or it could look beautiful. So whining is usually a lower level on the remote collar. It's usually a lower level on the remote collar. next.
Pam just read that. Sorry. Rose Brothers Dog Training. Finally made it to one of these. Keeps bumping me. Great to finally hear you live.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
Next. Rihanna, tips on teaching handler body awareness. Even when focused on me, he has a tendency to step on my feet. I step on his, run into my legs, etc. He's focused on me, seemingly unaware of my body's space.
That's a hard one sometimes. What I do is, you can actually carry a like a stick, like a hiking staff with you.
The chuck it stick works well.
Chuck it too. Stick. Yeah, just use a chuck it stick. Obviously, what Joelle does is she whacks the dog with a chuck it stick.
It's really good for that stuff.
Yeah, it works out great actually. Next.
Kiki, I'd heard that you may be coming back to Elkhart. Is there any truth to it? I really like Michelle's facility.
I've been to Elkhart four times. We'll be back again. Yes. Next. But Kiki, I'm going to be in Chicago. I'm going to be in Chicago next.
Ari, crittering. Looks like you backed away from this technique. Could you elaborate? I want to use it with my leash reactive dog who tends to react to dogs excessively.
It's not that I've backed away from it. It's that I only use it in very, very, very select situations. Normally, I'd rather just stop the unwanted behavior. So for leash reactivity, forget about crittering right now and just literally apply a punisher at the first signs of reactivity. That's going to be your best bet. That's going to be your most clear communication to the dog is going to be literally when your dog is starting to go up the sequence of leash reactivity, just shut it down. Next.
Ginger Beaches of Hawaii. My 9-month-old puppy has come a long way with her separation issues by following your advice. However, she still paces for 45 minutes when we put her in the kennel to leave the house. Any suggestions?
The paces, that means the kennel's too big. Your kennel's too big. Shrink your kennel down so the dog can pretty much just do nothing but lie down. Also, you can use the remote collar to, we're about to put up a video.
I'll put it up tomorrow.
There's a video tomorrow from the Collingwood seminar about how I just literally got a dog to lie down within about 3 seconds with a remote collar that has a habit of doing exactly the same thing. Next.
Rose Brothers Dog Training. When are you coming back to Indiana?
So probably, I don't know, I'm going to make probably in the, a year from when I was already there. So the one year after I was when I was there, which is probably the spring of 2020. Next.
Andrea, e-collar used to deter dog from obsessing over reflections, refractions, and water.
Yes.
Don't want dog adverse to water. Won't listen when being recalled when in that state of mind.
Okay. So yes, you will do that. You'll teach recall, number one. So teach recall, that's separate. And as far as all the reflections and stuff, being the OCD type dog, you can correct that. There's a big difference. So recall training is one thing. Teaching swimming is another. And stopping from OCD is another. So if you do all of them three separate, then you'll be fine. Next.
David, how do I help my 3-year-old Shepherd Husky become confident with other dogs after two?
We already did that one. Yep.
Kaylee J, good evening, Jeff and Joelle.
Hey, Kaylee.
Small engine Luca, when playing fetch, my dog has started returning to me and running halfway through my legs before stopping. How do I get him to stop before my feet, not between them?
What you can do is you're going to teach recall to front, which we don't do that much. Well, we do a little bit of that. We do. So recall to front into a sit. It's just not a competition front. So what you can do is put a place cot in front of you, recall to the place cot, or get like a little food dish. Get those rubber food dishes from Tractor Supply. Flip it over. So now it's like a disc. Recall the dog so it stands on the disc. Next.
Melissa posted the link to your seminars.
Awesome. Thank you.
Monica. Hi, Jeff. Teaching my deaf pit bull wait for food. Been working on this for a week. He gets super tense and shakes all over. He has a lot of trouble controlling himself to not grab the food. He started to down and face away from me.
Okay.
Seems like it helps him. I settled for this and wait some 30 seconds until I sign okay. As long as he does not move towards the food. Sometimes it takes 20 minutes or more.
Why?
Suggestions.
Yeah, it shouldn't take that long at all. It's a less than 5-minute process. We do this with young puppies as well. Take your food bowl up, put your food bowl down. The dog goes for it. Hold it up. All unspoken. Don't say wait. Don't say stay. Don't do hand signals. Okay? Down. Up. Down. Dog pauses. Give it to them. That's all. That's all you're trying to do. Like, you don't need your dog to totally be relaxed before they take food. You just don't. There's other impulse things you can do. Impulse activities you can do. Just have your dog. All I care about is my dog doesn't rush the food bowl. That's it. And that when I put my hand down, the dog backs away from the food bowl. Next.
Pam, he acts scared when the bonker comes out. He knows when e-collar is on and anticipates the correction before it even happens.
So you're not using the equipment correctly. So wake up in the morning. My dogs love the e-collar. So you're putting the e-collar on only for unwanted behaviors. Or maybe, oh, we're going to have a training session. Let's put the e-collar on. Wake up in the morning, put the equipment on your dog, dress your dog, start your day. Halfway through the day or every 4 hours or so, rotate the collar. Okay, rotate the collar. And then what I want you to do is use it for everything. And all remote collar training, we layer it with food as well. Or we do food training, layer it with a remote collar. It's not just for no. Next.
Monica, I already read that. Yep. Judy said, I had no intention of being rude. Sorry, it's just that the last couple Q&As had technical difficulties. So happy to see you.
Yeah, it's okay. We had technical difficulty. Yeah, we've had technical. We had login difficulty last time, so we sort of figured it out, and we're experimenting with a new system. I'm actually buying a new laptop tomorrow.
Oh, you are?
Yeah. Yep.
Cool.
Yep. I finally have to. I just have to.
Yeah.
This one is just. It's time. It's not able to keep up with the technology that I'm having.
Yeah.
Whether it's internet speed that I purchased.
You need your phone too.
Or software.
All the new technology.
Yeah, next. Go.
Nathan, my one-year-old dog sees my dad as the alpha in the main walker of the house and one who's training him while trying, but it seems inside the house, he always listens to my dad. Not a huge problem, but I don't know where the rest is. Oh, I'd like him to see me as the alpha, I guess.
Okay. Well, we can want and wish all we want to, but what are we doing about it? Who's that?
Nathan.
So Nathan, what are you doing about it, buddy? Right? What are you doing about it? So step up, work your dog, grab the leash, work the dog, and then don't let your dad butt in. Okay. So you do your own training sessions with the dog. Just be consistent with what your dad does. So you take the dog on walks. You do all the obedience training. You do the play. You do some feeding. You hold the dog accountable. You be demanding on the dog. Okay. And then you build that relationship with the dog. Next.
$4.99. Hey, Jeff, as a father of many children.
We did that one already.
We did?
I think so. Go ahead.
For the daughter to coexist?
Yes. Four dogs, one. Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
Kelly, we are so fortunate to have you providing all this amazing content. Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. Thanks for consuming it. I really appreciate it. Guys, if you like the show, give me a thumbs up. If you don't like the show, give me a thumbs down. If you have not joined the channel, hit the name of my channel to join, hit notifications. That would be really, really fantastic. Thank you so much. Next.
Unique. I've heard you say before that dog parks are a horrible idea, but how else can I get all my dog's energy out because walks don't help them?
Okay.
Much.
Listen, stop right there. Stop right there. A dog park is not to get your dog's energy out. Okay. So, and the walk is enough because you have to teach your dog how to be calm. But also you can put your dog on a long line, run your dog. Go to a field, get a 50-yard long line, a 100-yard long line, play fetch with your dog. Then it's always on a leash. Do one better, teach your dog how to be off-leash trained. But a dog park, the negativity will outfar weighs the positivity. So, you know, you can find other fenced in areas to run your dog around, but also you can go biking with your dog, running with your dog, structured walk with your dog is tiring, but teaching, get a treadmill, do duration work. And people say, oh, I don't have money for a treadmill, but guess what? One injury to dog park, you can buy five treadmills. I don't have space for a treadmill. Bullshit. I say bullshit to that. If you okay, I have an RV. I can put a treadmill in my RV if I wanted to. It'd be tight, but I could do it. But I assure you, where you live is probably bigger than an RV. My point is, get an RV for $50. I mean, a treadmill. Get it. I'll sell you my old RV for $50. Okay. All right. Next.
Ty Boogie, how do we build drive and keep them guessing?
Go to a sport dog. I don't build drive. I don't destroy it. I just don't build it. That's not what I do. I'm a family pet dog trainer. Building drive. I've owned drivey dogs, but building drive is not my level of expertise. Look for sport dog videos. That is what they do. That is exactly what they do. I'm a pet dog trainer. Well, we don't do that at all. Next.
Kendra, since I messaged you the other day, my Mal has thrived with the help of his e-collar. No more pushing the kids or other dogs. I now use it on walks and for commands. He even ignores dogs on walks. Thank you so much.
Proud of you. Thank you for doing the work. Next.
$1.99 from Monica. Appreciate your awesome work.
Awesome. Thank you so much for the $1.99.
You go, what would I do wrong? I stopped unwanted behavior, but he's scared of the bonker. He tries to avoid me when I have the bonker.
Okay. You didn't say no. So right here, I've got a bonker. Okay. I'm waving a bonker. My dogs are right next to me. So I got three dogs right there. I'm waving it around. Like this.
Scaring me.
My dogs aren't afraid of the bonker. They're not afraid of the bonker because I didn't say no. The tool they're not afraid of. They're not afraid of the bonker, and they're not afraid of my hand. And they're not afraid of my voice. All right? They're not afraid of my voice. If I hold this up, the dog can all of a sudden cower. All right? They're not afraid of this. Because what I did was I said no first. No, and then consequence. That's the magic. That's the magic. No, correct. No, bonk. Okay. Number one, Pitbull Dad. Jeff, how do I stop my dog from barking at dogs she sees passing by when she's looking up out the window? Excuse me, it happened so fast I don't even have time to correct. But well, this is the thing. Put a bark collar on your dog, number one. Number two, put a shock collar on your dog, have the handset on there, say no, and then correct your dog. Your dog barks, believe it or not, even if it stops barking, you can actually go say, as soon as you hear your dog barking, say no, go up to your dog, bonk it. As soon as your dog barks, say no. If the remote's not next to you, go grab the remote. You have time to correct. Next.
Pam, one-year-old border collie lab mix.
Okay. Is that a question? Oh, cool. Statement. Cool dog.
Next. Mackenzie.
Post a picture.
Found out what you put in your rice pudding, peanut butter.
See that, Mackenzie?
And raisins, though. You left that part out. Gross raisins.
Ducks. Gross raisins.
Bruce, what's your opinion on having to use backup collar with prong collar?
I think it's a good idea. I personally have never had one come apart, but people are, so it's always a good idea. Next.
Kyle, I'm also trying to train my six-month-old GSC puppy off-leash recall. I'm struggling with stopping him approaching other dogs on leash. He's never off leash around other dogs for this reason.
Yeah. So what you're going to start doing is this. Number one, on a walk, you would never want your dog to approach dogs, you know, at all. The walk is a selfish act between the human and the dog. And you become an island and you become a team. And you pretty much are not interacting with humans and dogs, but you're existing around many. So then as far as like socialization, you have a separate socialization. That's in a socialization setting, not on the streets of your city. Okay. So where would you do that? Would you do that, you know, in your fenced in backyard or in your backyard, or you're planning on meeting up, do a little meetup with some people at a public park. And then what you're doing is this, you can be practicing recall, find a dog in a fenced in area, recall dogs off that. But the first thing you do is teach your dog recall with no distractions. That's the first step. Next.
Shayna, do you think it's okay to post videos of me and dog that I trained last year just playing and being affectionate on the floor? He's a 140-pound King GSD. I want to show that a giant like that can also be funny and loving.
Why? Well, first of all, yes, you can do whatever you want to do with your own videos. It's your brand. It's your storytelling. But why are you trying to prove that a King GSD that's 140 pounds can be gentle and loving when we know that they can be? Who are you trying to prove that to? Who are you trying to prove that to, and why do you care? Why do you care what other people think about that dog? Why is that important? Think about that. Why is it important? And is it really important? But you can do anything you want. Absolutely. Next.
Crixis, hey guys, makes my day watching the dog swim. Tex perfected the ball smacker. Love that dog. Have a good evening. What's the ball smacker?
I have no idea. He doesn't have any balls. He ain't smacking him against the edge of the pool.
What the ball smacker?
I can see if he fell into the pool and his balls like hit the edge. Or if I had an intact male dog and he backed up to it and whacked his tail against the
dog's ball. You didn't say that on the thing?
The ball smacker?
Yeah. I feel like that's something you would have said for him to say that.
I throw a Kong in for him. I throw a floatable Kong.
Ball smacker.
Who's that? Crixus? Crixus, what the fuck are you talking about?
Ball smacker.
Next. Point out the ball smacker tomorrow when I do another live with my dog swimming. Next.
And my seven-month-old dog won't take no for an answer when another dog doesn't want to play with her. She'll chase and bark at them nonstop.
That's up to you.
Trainer says to redirect, but that doesn't
work. Fuck that, redirect. Jesus fucking Christ, are you serious? Other trainer says to fucking redirect. What are you, nuts?
My God. Zero to 100. Real quick.
I have redirect turrets. Tourette's.
Redirection. My God, you have a heart attack.
Next.
I can't even finish the freaking sentence. You didn't answer.
That was one run-on word, too. Sorry, I failed school. I never learned what a comma was.
You didn't answer it.
What's the question? Ask the question again.
The dog chases and barks at other dogs.
Okay.
To play.
Oh, so redirect it.
Won't back off.
Hold up a bone. Redirect it. Here you go, dog. Chase this instead. Next.
What the hell?
Correct it. So remote collar, no. Correct. Actually, if it was in a social situation in our socialization yard, we use a stockyard whip, believe it or not. Walk up to it. Whoosh, it's a little smack on the butt. Next.
Abby was thinking of using a stim reducer.
Excuse me, sorry. Oh my God, keep asking.
Okay. For my relatively low drive, but not sensitive dog to get more levels to work with. I don't think I'd ever need above 50. Wondering what you think of that.
Stim reducer is for people that are always below 5. You don't need a stim reducer. Next.
Top chat.
$4.99.
Drink. Did you click on it?
Thank you for answering me. One of my dogs runs full speed whenever he goes, and I'm always afraid of him knocking her over. Any tips to slow him down? Knocking who over, Marissa? To slow the dog down? The human down? I don't understand what that is.
I don't know. Who's
slow a dog. Right? Yeah, who's that? Slow the dog down. You put the dog on a leash. Slow them down. I don't know. I'm not sure. I need more context.
My dogs go fast everywhere.
Yeah, they go fast everywhere. And Kathleen did $2. Sorry. I don't know. Ask again. Next. But don't do it. Don't pay, but just ask again.
Leah, mad love and mad respect to you, Jeff.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
Head to tail dog training. Thanks. Owners were letting dog free feed. Told them to start using daily food to train.
Yep, absolutely. Or just feed twice a day, 10 minutes tops. Next. And then take it away.
Deanna, my dog is always panting, even as soon as he wakes up. In the video, you said this was excitement or maybe anxiety and to practice duration. But how do I do that exactly?
How do you practice duration? Teach place, teach down, leash on the dog. I've got free videos that will show you how exactly to do that. But also, see if there's any medical issues. Next.
Kathleen, a lot of people are saying having two or more dogs is best for the dog. Are families with a single dog doing the dog a disservice?
What? What are you, fucking nuts? Best for the dog? Says who? I mean, I got multiple dogs, don't get me wrong. But I know many people that have one dog and everybody's quite happy. They're quite happy. So... That's an interesting opinion. Are all those people also passing out checks to finance that whole fucking dog? Food, medical. Like here, like really? Okay, great. All those people should get a GoFundMe and pass out checks to all the people that they convince. Next.
JJ says, ha, 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 ha. Jennifer says, LOL.
Okay.
Jessica says, Jeff just turned on dad mode, LOL. Bruce.
I'm on dad mode 24/7.
What is your opinion on using backup collar with prong
collar?
You
already asked that. Next.
Okay. Well, he did it again. Okay. David Solomon says, LOL. What is everyone laughing at?
I have no idea.
Holding on dog training. Great show tonight. Love the rants. Thank you for all you do.
You're welcome.
Rescues and focused dog training. I'm getting a new pitty that should be good to go in July. One of our fosters is caring for the newborns right now. Someone dumped the pregnant mom. My new pup will be getting trained from day one.
Thank awesome. You. Awesome. Proud of you.
Next. Donde says, hi.
Hey, Donde. How are you, buddy?
Gigi, any tips for a dog that will poop in the kennel? He is housebroken, healthy, and will be fine when outside the kennel. He doesn't care if it's a small kennel and will stomp through it. Oh.
Okay. I don't have any good ones. I'm not the pooping PGI. I'm just not good at that. All right? I'm just not. Massive schedule. Watch the dog's diet. Check for worms. Probably not an issue. It's probably behavioral. Dog is reverse housebroken. It's a pain in the fucking ass. Take the crate, think about lowering the top of the crate, not permanently, but lowering the top of the crate so that the dog cannot stand up. It sounds mean. It's like, no, your dog's not in the torture chamber. This is not forever. But it's like you can get in the crate and lie down. Not to say the dog can't poop lying down, but man, you have to have a certain skill set to do that. And if you should, you go to the fucking circus with shit like that. So that's what I'm going to suggest next. But I would consult some folks that like love working with poop and housebreaking issues. That's not my flavor of the month. Next.
I was just made a crude joke, but I would not do it. Unique. When I get home from work, I always find pee outside of the crate. Yes, he's locked in and hasn't escaped, but somehow he's peeing outside the gate.
Yeah, he? Damn right. Mm-hmm. Us dudes have fucking skill, all right? We can twist our dicks in a knot and still fucking use them.
My God.
Okay? So that's what it is. That's what it is. So what you do is this, plexiglass. Plexiglass the damn crate. Next.
Kendra, I hear you talk about double down.
Double down is when you take the head and it goes all the way to the ground. You do that with low level remote collar pressure, leash pressure, verbal down again. Next.
This chair is killing me tonight.
Is it?
Yes, it is. Kendra, good evening, Jeff and Joelle.
Hello, how are you, Kendra?
Deanna, is it safe to leave remote collar on the dog and leave the house?
Yeah. I mean, you know, people do it in the crates all the time, you know? They do it in the crates all the time. Outside, I'd be super careful about having any cow on your dog, technically, because you can get caught up on a railing and the dog can suffocate. Next.
Amanda, can you put a prong collar on all day, like you said, with the e-collar?
You can, but it depends. Some of your dogs with no fur and some of your white dogs, they can get white dogs, it'll turn silver gray. And some of your dogs with not a lot of fur, they get abrasions sometimes. You know, they can get abrasions just from the metal. So you can get an allergy-free, a nickel-free one. But also, you want to be home. A prong collar should be left on when there's a leash attached to it. Always just think about it that way. Next.
Amanda, can you also put a prong? I just read that. Yep. Pam, see you in September. I'm not using e-collar until I get trained.
That's fine. Even though you can, but that's fine. Next.
Karen, GSD lover, when you do that technique with the food bowl, does the dog need to totally ignore the bowl, look away, or can he look at it? My dog will stare at it. Is this okay? Happy Father's Day too.
Thank you so much. If you want the dog to look away, use a remote collar and just do a low remote collar to get the dog to physically and mentally disengage. If I have a dog that does not resource guard, I don't care. Next.
Svenja says, good evening, guys.
Hey, good evening.
Kyle, after commenting the other day, asking about my GSD puppy mouthing my hands and arms, I took your advice, made a bonker, and used that. 100%, it's working a lot quicker than I expected as well.
Yeah, the bonker is incredible. If anyone's not familiar with the bonker, it is a towel wrapped up. You say no. I've got videos on this, okay? Also, for all the dads out there, happy Father's Day. I really appreciate all of you, not just the dads, but I really appreciate you. I think being a dad and being a father and shaping our children is one of the greatest gifts that we can ever do. And we all should be taking that extremely responsibly. Okay? Next.
JJ, I always like the shows. I don't even have a dog yet.
So
that's awesome.
Yeah. Some people are never getting a dog and they still watch the show. Next.
Top chat. Marissa.
So $4.99. So sorry, I was the one with the four dogs with the 1 year old. Got it. One of them runs around the house full speed. Mm. Okay. Got it. Thank you. Okay. Full speed. Okay. That needs to stop tonight. Do you have a shock collar? No shock. If not, make a bonker. First of all, be proactive. These dogs, okay, let's just start. Stop right now. Just stop the show right now. Okay. Marissa, you have four dogs. You have a 1 year old child. You know this. That is why you are here. You're also new. Welcome. I don't want to scare you away at all. This show is a little bit different than actually how I train. It's not as how I train. I'm not in your face. I'm not yelling. I'm not screaming. I'm not saying fuck. I'm not saying tits, ass, cock, shit, all that stuff like I do on this show. Okay. I take it very, very seriously. But let's have a serious conversation right now. I want you to own four crates. I want them all lined up. I want you to have four prong collars. I want you to have four leashes. I want you to teach each one of those dogs how to go in and out of a crate politely. I want you to teach all those dogs how to go into a crate and lie down. I've got free videos on all of this stuff, politely. I want you to teach those dogs all how to go to place. Places, go to a dog bed, go to a mat. Don't give up. Don't get up. I want you to do that, okay? All this you can do in less than 2 weeks, Okay. You do one dog at a time. Put that dog back in the crate. Take out the second dog. Back in the crate. Third dog. Back in the crate. Fourth dog. Teach each one a skill a day and then reinforce it. As the dogs get more responsible, they can come out of the crate more and lie there. So at our training center, we have 12 dogs out doing nothing, and Angelo is running around the room. I have videos on this. It's not because we're dog trainers. It's because we give out this. We do exactly what's in our videos. Get yourself a four-dog remote collar. Four-dog remote collar. It's one handset, four dogs. Okay? The dog that's running around, what you can do immediately is this. The reason why I'm saying this is because it just shows you don't have control over the dog, which is not your fault at all. It is absolutely not your fault. That is why you are here, okay? So, but to me, no dog should be doing that. What I want you to do is I want you to make sure those other three dogs are put away. I want, when that fourth dog is running around, I want you to grab a bonker. It's a towel. You can make one tonight. You don't have to go on Amazon. They're free, okay? These are rubber bands. I've got a video, how to make a bonker, on my YouTube channel. I want you, when that dog is running around, I want you to say, no, calmly, as calm as you can. And then I want you to, you're going to have to go up to that dog. You got to get that dog, follow that dog, hunt that dog down if you have to. I want you to say no, and then bonk. Where do you hit? Right in the head area. Yep, I know. It sounds mean. It sounds abusive. I'm telling you to freaking whack your dog with a towel. What I'm actually trying to do is trying to save your child's life. Okay? Even if you didn't have a kid, I want you to do this as well. Now the dog is going to go, holy shit. What the fuck was that? Good. I've got your attention, don't I now? Now, let's work. But your dog should be on a leash and a prong collar and should not be running around anyway. But that's how you're going to stop that. Okay? I want you to take back your home. Take back your home. Next.
And Lacey gave a thumbs up.
Good. Thank you.
Dawn, let's see. Jeff, my dog lets out a low growl when he's eating. He has a few bites under his belt due to resource guarding.
Okay, that stops. No, correct. Next. Teach the out command. I've got it on my YouTube channel. Next.
Carly G. You ready? It's got four parts.
It's Carly short. G. It's not fucking allowed.
It's her first time.
Carly, first and last.
First and last.
One, we'll let it slide. One module you can ask a question. Next.
It's semi-short. Carly, saw your IG post about your son existing around your dogs. Love it. I instill the same mentally with my children.
Okay.
Visit family's house at the lake. Would love to teach dog to create bubble around people while in the water. Same as on land with e-collar.
Yep.
He turns into a shark.
Nope.
That's what I do. It works. The bonker works.
Okay. Is that the question?
Yeah.
So you want to know how to do it in the water?
That's all parts, okay. Yes.
So this is how I do it in the water. I've got a great picture of it. I don't know if I have a video. This goes back 6 years, maybe back. This goes back maybe 6 years. Because I was working dogs at my house. Humongous Rottweiler, 110-pound Rottweiler, in the water, swimming towards Romy. So Romy was 6 years old at the time, same age as Angelo, going right at him, right her, right at her. She's the one on Instagram stories with a pantsuit tonight. That's right at her. Got it? Remote collar. I made it suck to go towards a kid, make it suck to go towards an adult. Got it? That's how you do it. That's how you do it. Next. But it also starts on land as well. Next.
Taneo, steps for off-leash training with the mini educator.
Start with on-leash training, lead to off-leash training. Start with on-leash training first, get control over your dog, layer the remote collar over it so it understands the remote collar on a leash, and then work towards off-leash. It's stages. You do it with a leash drop. Dog has to be up to understand what no means before you can actually start dropping a leash. Next.
Teresa. Hey, Joelle. Hey, Jeff. Wow, she said my name first.
That's great. You can say your name
Happy
first
Father's
every time.
Happy Father's Day. Wanted to update you guys. I got in with our local shelter, and they are pro-correction. Thank you for all the free content that has given me more skill.
Awesome. Good. Document.
She said so much love to you guys.
Love to you as well.
Kim, unfortunately, I had a prong collar come apart.
Yep. Okay. So that's always usually, it's sometimes it's manufactured defect. Historically, it's handler error. So use a backup collar. My buddy Sean O'Shea, if everybody goes to thegooddog.net, his shopping cart, which might be actually thegooddogway.com, just go to Sean O'Shea, thegooddog.net. And on his shopping cart, he just designed a new leash. It's a double leash. It has two pieces at the end. One goes on, say, the prong. Another one goes on a flat buckle collar. So if it comes off, you're still connected. Next.
Unique. My dog stops listening to me when he starts playing with people and other dogs. How do I get him to listen to my sit, stay, and come command?
When your dog is playing with other dogs, you don't want it to sit. You don't want it to stay. You want it to come to you. That's it. That's all you really care about is your dog comes to you. To take a dog and drive, to do sit and drive is challenging. People do it, but that's an advanced skill set. Okay. So first, what you do is you do recall. Your dog has to be able to recall to you with no distractions, no environmentals. Then you start adding in environmentals. Then you need to get your dog up to correction mode. So your dog will correct, will recall to you when it doesn't want to recall to you and it understands what a punisher is. So your dog has to understand the conversation first. Then you put it around dogs and you role play when the dog is in low drive. And then you do it when the dog is in high drive. It's multi-layered. It's a multi-layered approach. Next.
Rescues and wolf training, socializing it in a controlled environment.
That sounds really, really good. Get it to exist around lots of people. Shut up whining. Make it sit before everything. Four on the floor. Stop it from jumping. Stop it from mouthing. No whining, no barking. Next.
You go. Oh, yes. I didn't say no before I bonked. That's why. I will fix it from today.
It's the most important part, guys. Guys, every single time that I pull this bonker out, in all of my videos and all of my seminars and all of my live feeds and all of my, in everything I do, I always say, grab the bonker, say no, bonk. 1 second, 2 seconds. Every single time I say it every single time. And it's, why am I saying it's, it is the most important part. It's the most important part. That's why your dog's afraid of it. Because it thinks when you pick something up, it's going to be hit with it. Because you didn't say no. So when you see me in my seminars, when we're doing like 20 dogs, this is underneath my arm. I'm not doing this to scare dogs. I'm doing this in case I need it for a dog. So the dogs aren't behaving because of this. They're like, I might need to deploy it on a dog when there's 22 dogs at a weekend seminar. I need to be able to say no and go up to it. So it's really important. I'm not mad at you either, by the way. I'm passionate. A lot of people are like, geez, Jeff, I've been getting a lot of comments lately. There must be from people that are new to the show. God, you're talking really down to your clients. Like, yeah. First of all, you've never seen me actually work with a client, obviously. Mm-hmm. Never been to one of my seminars at all. Why is it when people come to my seminars, they say how loving and caring I am, but some asshole fucking, you know, stupid shit number 42 in living in Omaha has got to be like, oh my God, you're really like, you should talk friendlier to your clients. I'm like, first of all, like, they're fans and I love you. But it's like, second of all, it's like, you don't know what you're talking about. It's always interesting. Perception. They don't get this. No. They don't get that this is an entertainment show.
No.
They don't understand.
Every time people meet us in person, they're like, oh, right. You're nothing like the internet.
It's like, yeah, no, you're actually like really quiet.
I'm actually really quiet.
Yeah. And we talk normal. Next.
You go. I already read that. Karen. Finally, I was able to walk both dogs at the same time. Thanks to your advice.
Awesome.
Now they get much longer walks and seem to get along better.
She just asked that the other day.
She did.
Oh my gosh. Right.
That was on
twice as well. Yeah.
What day are we at? Yeah.
Wednesday show. Kudos to you.
Now they get much longer walks. They seem to get along better in the house. Does awesome. It matter which dog is ahead? They are both at heel, but one seems to get ahead.
Yeah, you're always going to have a little bit ahead
than the other.
Try putting them both a little bit behind your knee. Try to put them both in follow mode. Next.
Valentina. Hi, guys. How do I teach my dog to ignore people, other dogs, when she's off leash and I see she wants to go approach someone?
Never let the dog do that.
Because people pet her.
Yeah.
I correct her and she doesn't go. Is that okay?
Yeah. Stop letting people pet your dog. Your dog will be fine. Nobody pets my dogs. You can pet my dog. My dogs are extremely social. Like, my dogs are very, very, very social. But they ignore people. People are always like, geez, what's wrong with your dogs? I'm like, what do you mean what's wrong with my dogs? Like, they're ignoring me. I'm like, sorry for bruising your ego, but my dogs don't give a shit about you. How did I get that way? My dogs don't go up to people. No, you can't pet my dog. No, you can't. If you call my dog over to you, I'm going to make sure my dog gets corrected if it does. I don't want my dog going up to you. They're my dogs. So be selfish. Become a selfish dog owner. It is the safest way to own a dog. Next.
Taneo, my dog has learned the eye focus distraction training you posted very well. Is there any further I can do that is more challenging?
I mean, work your dog hard hold your dog accountable, you'll get all the focus you want. Next.
Monica, 2019, jogging this morning, a young woman with a GSD, dog launching and barking at me. The girl hugged the dog, petting it, saying, "It's okay, girl. No worries. She should do it to me. I was scared."
Yeah, exactly. You'd be like, where does the line start? Me next? Yeah. So obviously, we all know that's the worst thing to do. That's the worst thing to do. And I wouldn't say that to her. Like, if I was people are like, you know, say I said that happened to me. People would be like, you should have given your business card. First of all, I don't have business cards. Second of all, why would I ever do that? Yeah. Like, I'm not an ambulance chasing dog trainer. Like, mm-hmm. I don't give out advice to people with badly behaved dogs that I see on the street ever. Like, if you want to have a badly behaved dog, that's on you.
Yeah.
If it lunges at me, I'm not going to say I can help you. I'll say, get the fuck away from me. Mm-hmm. Like everybody else should. Yeah, but I'm like, people always do this. Like, that's not how I get business.
Yeah.
Yeah. Next.
Natalie knew what would Jeff do. Correct. Don't redirect.
Yeah, exactly. Next.
Scott, my friend, has a 6-month male German Shepherd, and I have 10-month-old male Doberman. They get on well, play rough sometimes. Is this okay, or should we keep them separated?
It's okay. Keep an eye on it. They have not hit maturity yet. Okay? So if you're gonna let these play rough, make sure you can say enough and it stops instantly. We're talking instantly. If you're gonna teach your dogs how to play tug, you better teach them how to release. If you're gonna teach your dogs how to go into drive, you better be able to all of a sudden put them into a calm state of mind instantly. Your dogs aren't even a year old yet. Be careful. Shit gets different then. Shit gets real, as we say. Next.
Good show. Mackenzie says the peanut butter sounds good with it, but I don't know about the raisin part.
Okay.
I do like raisins though.
So Mackenzie,
gross.
Mackenzie, you're already on strike five.
Doesn't like sushi.
Okay.
Doesn't like coffee.
Okay. You drink sweet tea.
Okay.
So you're on strike five. Okay. I haven't even hired you yet and you're already on probation. So watch yourself.
Don't worry. I'll back you up on that. Nobody likes rice pudding with peanut butter. John says hello.
Technically.
Here we go.
Technically.
Ding, 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 ding. We struck a chord.
12.05 a.m. I climb out of bed in the RV. I grab a spoon.
Rummaging around.
There's no rummaging around. I go into the spoon that's probably in the dryer rack from being washed at night because we do our dishes daily. I open up the second cabinet to the right. I pull out the plastic bin that has the peanut butter. There's two things of peanut butter in there.
Yeah, okay. The good shit and the not good shit.
I unscrew the cap. I take out a scoop. I put it all back. I open up the fridge. I take out the rice pudding. I scoop it in the rice pudding.
I know.
Listen to me, though.
What do you eat it bite by bite? Like,
listen, one scoop of peanut butter, it sort of stays on there throughout the whole rice pudding.
Yeah.
So it's not like I take the whole thing up. So it's like it's pretty cool. It's almost like dipping a popsicle into like something.
But it's peanut butter into rice pudding.
Yeah.
Ugh. Texture. Huh? That makes me just like want to vomit thinking about it. Chunky and.
How about those shaker drinks you make?
A protein shake?
Yeah.
It's just a protein
shake. Yeah, I know. I like those too. Okay.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. Justin.
I'll figure something out to make fun of you at next time.
Everything. I'm far from normal. Advice for owning different breeds of dogs. Do's and don'ts. I have a black lab and want a Malinois. Different breeds under the same roof.
Okay, well, a Malinois is not a different breed. It's like owning a dinosaur. So I don't know your skill set. I don't know what your skill set is. I don't know what your lifestyle is. And there are being a lot of badly bred Malinois out there now because everybody wants one, but nobody should technically own one. So a Malinois can be an extremely, extremely, extremely challenging dog. And it's not because, oh, well, if you exercise it enough, that has nothing to do with it. You can run your Malinois 50 miles a day and I'm still going to give you you're still going to own an extremely challenging dog and you own an athlete now. Okay. So Malinois can be really, people see these Malinois that are all well-trained. Okay. But that's because someone did lots and lots and lots of training. And that still doesn't mean they know how to be calm. That still doesn't mean that they know how to be calm at all. They might kettle them up, when they're not doing all the fancy stuff. Next.
Kaylee J, roommate moving out end of July, so I'm finally going to start training friends, family, dogs for free just for the experience for me to see if dog training as a job is awesome. For me. So excited.
Awesome. Proud of you. Next.
Jess. Hi, Jeff and Joelle. I have a 6 month service dog in training and two old dogs who had zero training as pups. Mm. Don't know how, if much trainability there. Know some tricks, some basic obedience, bad anxiety, were abused, neglected. Any advice?
Okay. Forget that. Okay. Never, ever, ever say they were abused and neglected. Never. They're your dogs now. And how long have you owned them for? They're older dogs. Did you adopt them old, or were they abused and neglected? Have you been saying that story for 5 years? So abused and neglected, first of all, how do you know? Second of all, it doesn't matter. Teach them duration work. It's because the issue is what? They don't know how to be they don't know how to relax. Teach them how to relax by doing long downs, long place, and then fully obedience train them. Tricks, we don't do tricks. We just do training. Next.
Top chat, $4.99.
Remember, you guys are the best. Awesome. And you're allowed to bring the 1 year old because I get to.
He gets to hold it.
So 1 year old, and when is it? And can it be September? That's month nine. We're in month six right now. 3 months. You have a 15-month old toddler running around. Yeah, if we can keep that kid quiet, you can go. Next.
Jessica, I've been setting my dog up to stop him from jumping at food. I've had the e-collar on 50 and he still blew through it. Should I go to 100? What is too high? I'm scared, so I haven't done it.
Okay. I know you're scared. You know why? You're afraid you're going to hurt your dog. I don't want to hurt your dog either. 100 for 3 seconds on the continuous button. Set it up. Okay. Here's, take the food, put it on a plate, roll the tower up to 100, get out of the room, hide, set up a video camera, let the dog jump up. When the dog gets up, hold the button down for 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3. You shouldn't enjoy it. It's going to suck watching. The dog will not enjoy it. A lot of people think it's mean and abusive. Obviously, none of you have seen rattlesnake training before. Okay? And you will save your dog's life. Because your dog taking shit off the counter will end up killing it one day or costing you thousands of dollars in money. Thousands of dollars at the vet office. Next.
Carly, don't give up, Marissa. Seriously, I've taught my dog through all of Jeff's videos. Yep. Take notes and do the work. Stay patient.
Yep.
I have a 7-year-old and a 1-year-old too.
Yep. Yep. Everybody can be successful. How successful? It's not necessarily your skill set. Also, dogs have caps. Next.
Jess, do you have any advice for me home training my service dog in training? 6 months with two senior dogs.
Sure, yes.
8 and 9 years. It's like it's the same question, but a different format.
Oh, okay.
What all should my pup know at 6 months?
Well, if you have a service dog in training, I don't know what the tasks are. I don't know what you're going to be. I don't know what the job of the dog is going to be. But your dog needs to have at a minimum public access, which is what the training we would do. So forget the tasks right now. Forget all the tasks. But let's just talk about the public access training that you're going to want, the level you're going to want. You want to be able to have a dog that you can take everywhere, anywhere, with almost any environmental out. So you need an environmentally sound dog. Most dogs are not qualified to be service dogs. Dogs that are bred for service dog have a high of a 90% washout rate. 90%. 9 out of 10 dogs that are in the litter that were bred for service dogs may wash out 1 year. So the average is, I think, 50. Okay. So we're talking real service dogs, true service dogs here. So you want to be able to have a dog that can go on airplanes, cars, trains, buses, the subway. You want a dog that can do a 3 to 4 hour downstay easily. If you fly with your dog, that could be a 6 hour downstay. You want to have a dog that can be around all dogs and all people without reacting around loud noises and badly behaved dogs and badly behaved people. You want a dog that is not reactive, that has no separation anxiety, that has no anxiety at all. You want a dog that will walk next to you politely and will not ever pull on a leash. You know, those are some minimum requirements. Next.
Top chat.
Five. What is that? Euros. Kyle. Thanks, guys. My 6-month-old GSD is doing well because of your advice taken from your streams every week. Once I crack recall, he will be perfect. Awesome. And just remember, 6 months old, don't let your guard down. A year old, these dogs start going... Fuck you, Kyle. They will do that. They will do that. It's like, what happened to you? It's like all this time, all this bonding, all this relationship, all this shit I've done for you, and you flip me off. Welcome to
dog ownership.
The dog ownership of a year old. So just keep up with it. Keep up with it. Next.
Rescues and focused dog training. Happy Father's Day, by the way.
Thank you so much.
I and most of the people at the shelter love your videos and podcasts. Also, bananas and salads are delicious.
Thank you so much. Next. Move on. Move on.
Katie, six-year-old husky doing board and train with me has meltdown before training session and prong and e-collar. Also, anxious when we head into high distraction areas, screams with correction from either collar.
Yeah. Okay. There's an art to this. If you want to slip, if you want to change to a slip lead right now, you can, or a martingale, you can right now. But chances are it's an objection from a dog that's never been told what to do. Everybody assumes it's the tools. There's an art to this, though. You're going to have to work this dog in a low environmental area for a while. What's a while? I don't know your skill set. Could be a week, could be 2 weeks, could be 3 weeks. Everybody's like, and this is the thing, you will start, there are more, when you really work with dogs, like when you're getting into this rehab business, you're getting a lot of dogs that are just genetically struggling. And I'm not blaming the dog here, guys. First of all, it's not the dog's fault. But there are a lot of just unsound dogs out there. And you have to have a certain skill set. And you have to be creative as fuck to try to get through to these dogs. Like sometimes it takes us weeks to get through to a dog for basic obedience. We have other dogs. Boom. In one day, we can teach them technically everything. They're not good at it, but we can teach it to them. There's other dogs that take 3 days to get them to be able to come out of a crate in a reasonable fashion.
Yeah, so true.
All right? And we have skills. So there's a lot. So slow down on that. Next.
Unique. When I'm driving, my dog keeps hopping in the front. One time I was going 70 on the freeway and he hit the car in neutral. How do I stop this? I bought a seat hammock thing to block him off, but he just hops over it.
Okay, number one. What are you doing 70 unless you're in Texas? And then you can go 85.
It's like 65 most places.
I know.
Which means 70.
If Angela was here, he would say 70 is 5 more than 65. Okay. So, all right. Oh, in the left. Officer, I was in the left lane. Isn't that the plus 25?
They say 9 is fine, 10, you're mine. I know a lot of cops.
I'm sure you do. Okay. They're 6'5", 250 pounds with abs.
With abs.
That are not on steroids. Okay. So what I want you to do is this. Number one, get a fucking decent goddamn divider. Or put your dog in a crate or put a seat. Get one of those harnesses with a seatbelt thing. Next. Or teach your dog how to do a downstay in the back seat. That's what I would do. I would just teach the dog how to do it down in the back seat. We do that with all of our client dogs. Next.
Two-year-old German Shepherd Lab Mix, highly reactive on and off leash to other dogs. Just bought educator collar, but even at level 30 plus, his focus on going to that dog will not break. Any tips? Thank you.
Yeah. So what I want you to do is this. I don't know your training skills. I don't know your timing. What you need to do is dogs on a leash, remote collars on the dog. What I want you to do is the very beginning of the sequence of the arousal, correct. And now how high? 30 plus, 30 plus what? 30 plus 70, 30 plus 5, 30 plus 10. Don't be worried about the number. Pay attention to the dog. What's the dog doing? At the beginning, you also might want to be utilizing a little bit of distance, but apply your punisher at the first sign of arousal. Next.
Carly says, no is the marker. Correct. Don't redirect. Can we get a t-shirt?
Sure. Next.
Slides and spoons. All of this has clicked in my head. We used weird corrections, loud noises like quarters in a can for my dog, and she would just shut down. E-collar and your methods have done wonders.
Yep. Exactly. I'm not against the penny can, but everybody assumes the penny can is nicer than a shock collar. Says who? I've seen dogs piss themselves when they hear the penny can. They literally piss themselves when they hear a penny can. And there's other dogs that are like, okay, I'll stop that with a shock collar. Like, but oh no, it's a penny can. It's okay. We're not actually touching the dog. You know, next. Bogdana. Hey, Bogdana, how are you? Best wishes to you. Happy early Father's Day, Jeff. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thanks, everybody. Next.
Blue on black, unique. My dog had a harness that fixes the seatbelt. He managed to tie himself in knots.
Jeez.
That almost broke his leg and chewed the seatbelt enough to have to replace it. €200 worth.
Got it. Holy shit. Yeah, we're a big advocate of double downing in the back of the car. Next.
Rihanna, any suggestions, recommendations for budget-friendly e-collars? Need a new one, and I want something reliable, but can't afford 100 plus for one at this time. Let my sister mine. Her dog ate it. Don't ask.
Okay. So how the fuck did that happen? Number one. Number two, your sister owes you the money. Okay? So tell your sister, no smoking, no drinking, no purchasing of food, make your own food, no coffees out, no new purchases at all. 100% of any extra revenue goes to you until she's made up the difference. You want something good and cheap? Okay. No. Not going to happen. The remote collar from eCollar Technology is going to be your most budget-friendly one. It's $180. You might be able to get a used one from somebody. Next.
Amanda, how do I teach my 4.5-month-old to learn to ignore others' dogs?
That's what dogs do. So right now, just have your dog. It's going to be challenging right now. Have your dog on a leash. Just be around. Try to just get past a lot of dogs. Teach your dog how to start walking on a leash properly. So prong collar, 2.25-millimeter prong collar. Teach the dog a proper heel with no environmental distractions. Start adding low-level distractions. Start adding going by other dogs. And then don't let your dog go over to the other dogs. Next.
Monica, what about wait for food? It takes a long time for him to stop trying to grab it right away. I'm not sure how long I need to wait.
Well, wait for food. I mean, for me, I do it for first of all, I don't have fucking time. This is the thing. It's like, I want to feed my dogs. So all my dogs line up. You've seen me in the RV, right? You've seen me feed my dogs in the RV. They're all in a down on the ground outside the RV. Okay. Three dogs. I take their food bowls. I do meal prep with my dogs. So I put the food in the bowl. So I got all three bowls now in front of them, all filled with food. They're all lying down. That's all I care about. And then I'll say, Tex, put the bowl to the left. Kira, put the bowl in the middle. Girl, put the bowl off to the right, and they eat them. That's all I care about. That's all I care about. I pick my battles other places. Like, for the longest time, I did cloth diapers as a family. We did cloth diapers. For the longest time, we did cloth diapers. And then one day, we said, you know what? Let's save the environment in another way, and we bought disposables. I'm picking my battles on a lot of this stuff. Next.
The laundry would be an ending with those.
It not. We installed. Have you ever been in our laundry room at the house?
No.
I installed a fucking toilet in the laundry room with a hose coming from the water source, an external hose, like you would use for like washing dishes, to spray the fucking diapers down. And it would go into the toilet, then go into the laundry machine. It's down there right now. I literally installed a toilet in the laundry room for poopy diapers. I mean, the plumbing was there. Our laundry room is, the house has got like six bathrooms. You know, it's an old house. So the laundry room was an old bathroom. So the toilet used to be there. So we just installed a new one and I installed this adapter to it. Nobody shits or pisses in this toilet.
Yeah.
Nobody uses it all. Right now it fucking holds like dry clothes.
Cloth diapers.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's just like so much laundry.
No shit.
No way. Top chat. Steve C.
Yep.
God. $9.99. Joelle, I can only afford $9.99. I used to go to the gym. I'm old, chubby, and gay. That lawyer needs to get off my cloud. See you at San Francisco.
See.
That's funny.
So just so you know, okay, Joelle's going on with Steve. Okay. Okay.
I'll go with Steve.
Okay. I'm pretty sure Joelle's not dating guys.
I'm not.
Just to let you know, I'm pretty sure. Mm-mm. I mean, I'm pretty sure. So,
Joseph.
Yeah.
Hi, Jeff. Joelle, it was great meeting you today. Deb Pequin.
Oh, good.
Likewise.
Oh, wait, Deb. Wait, hold this. Deb, the one with the boat. The one.
I think that's
Deb met you or me.
I don't know. Hey.
Oh, Joelle. On the walk.
Yeah.
Oh, the walk. I'm sorry. It's like we
had a lot of people coming in today.
I know, and I met a lot of them because I did the pack walk today. And Deb. Sorry, so sorry. Yes, because I remember I met a new one-on-one client today, and I normally don't see a lot of the clients.
Yeah.
So, but you're right. I did the walk today. It was really nice to meet you as well. Next.
Steve, I have found that my lab, the bonker, is consistently more effective than the e-collar.
Yeah.
Except, of course, at distance.
Yes. Correct. Or in another room with a wall. Yep. Next.
You're wearing Crocs.
Yeah. I took the dog swimming today, and it's warm out.
Megan, dog selective dog, great with all dogs while on leash, walking or sitting next to them. But when in play yard, he lunges, barks, bites at certain dogs. How to work through?
Right now, I would be really, really careful about the dog socialization aspect of your dog's life. What I would do is actually I would start with the dog. I would get a dressage whip, stockyard whip. Any arousal, you correct that. Also, I don't know how you run your socialization. If it's like is it a free for all? Is it controlled? Does everybody know the rules there? There's a lot of variables. If your dog is just running loose in a yard though, with not a lot of supervision and a lot of like-minded owners, it might not be the best thing. Next.
Gary, Jeff, teaching energy level in humans, my family, is harder than all the dog training. Can't amp the dogs up, then freak out that they're not listening. Thoughts?
You know, you have to have read the riot act to your family. Put your dog away. Just say, listen, the dog's not, I'm not bringing the dog, or I'm putting the dog away. You guys can't handle this shit. Mm-hmm. You guys can't handle it. Don't complain. Next.
Slides and Spoons says, oh my, poorly bred Malinois now.
Which one? Oh, yeah. Just in general,
like these days.
Yeah. I mean, there is next.
A new top chat, $25.99.
Oh, do you see it? Mm-hmm. Why don't you read it?
From Julie, 1 year GSD, 6 year GSD mix, both 70 pounds. Yep. Issue with fetch with both at the same time. GSD hog six, ends in dog fight. Only time they fight is fetch. Eat, sleep, play, tug together, no problem. Tried e-collar on GSD when lunging, but stopped plug fetch.
Okay, so what I want you to do is this. So it's funny because I'm thinking it's a drop when they're in drive, but if they play tug and they don't fight, usually tug is drive as well. So this is what I would do. I would teach some really good impulse control. Have a dog, keep the one that you feel is the one that's starting it. It's most likely the older one, not the six-month-old one, most likely. And I could be wrong, but six-month-old dogs, they might start fights, but their intentions are not to fight. Keep that one on a leash, play fetch with the other one, teach the other one to be in a down, let the other dog observe fetch, and then swap them out. And then what you might want to do, and this doesn't necessarily fix the problem, one ball goes to the right, one ball goes to the left, okay, until they start getting used to that. So that's one of those ones where I probably would muzzle up probably the one-year-old dog and correct it. And then the next step, what I would do is I'd put a muzzle on the one-year-old dog, put remote collars on both, let them both run for it. If the one-year-old dog tries to nail the puppy, correct that one high. Next.
Ari, for a rough playing dog, would you use an e-collar for correcting? My bull Arab, you've seen her on Insta, will corner my whippet, mouth, push, and punch him, and he's too sensitive for that.
Yeah, I would. So beautiful dog, by the way. What I would do is, I don't want to wait until the first time. Normally I do that. We'll wait until the first time it does that and then go, that's a bad choice. What I would do is when the dog starts getting overly aroused like that, just correct it. And the dog's just going to have to learn how to play gentler with the whippet. Next.
Jess, what's the oldest dog you've trained had at a seminar?
At a seminar? Well, trained is 12 years old. The oldest dog I've had at a seminar? I usually don't ask ages, though. That's the thing.
Yeah.
I don't ask ages, nor do I ask the name of the dog unless I'm training recall. But your dog can't be too old to be there. Like if your dog is breathing, you bring the dog there and it'll do fine. If it's not breathing, we'll impress everybody with a good downstay, right? Next.
Katie, thank you for the advice. Have mid go home lesson with owners tomorrow.
Cool. Next.
Monica, suggestions for making the best out of hiking and crossing water creeks with boulders and such for confidence building. He's been making progress, but looks like he's afraid of water and losing his footing, and I'd like to make the best of it.
Yeah.
He's prong collar when we hike, but wondering if it's a good idea when confidence building.
Yeah, it is. Just remember, wet rocks are slippery rocks. That's one of the mantras that we had when I was backpacking with my kids. I used to be a huge, huge backpacker. And obviously, moss on logs and moss on rocks are slippery as fuck. What you need to do is, you actually can just teach the dog, it depends on the speed of the water and the depth of the water. My dogs would usually just go right through the water. But what I would do is I would get those plastic, what are those discs called that we have, those that Angela uses to walk on?
Oh, like the wobble balls.
The little wobble balls, yeah. But it's not like a ball, it's like a flat peg. There's the fit paws, like fit paws. Yeah. Like fit paws makes those. I would start teaching your dog how to walk on those, different surfaces, things like that. Also you can get pieces of wood and lay them on the ground and get your dog to go from wood to wood to wood. You can raise up a ladder and you can do stuff like that. But yeah, a prong collar is fine for that. Next.
Kinsey says Angelo is the cutest.
Thank you so much. Angelo is a really cool kid.
Next. Contrail says, thanks, Jeff.
He wore clothes in the swimming pool today.
Wow.
Yeah, he normally is naked.
Is he too old to be naked?
No, he's not too old. I'm not sure what was going on. Pool. I know Linda wants him to have a hat on. Mm. That I know, but that's the hat.
Yeah.
He wore like this t-shirt thing and shorts. And I'm like, Angelo, you're like, we call you Naked Angelo for a reason.
Yeah.
Did you see that Sun Made Raisins made a comment on his?
I tagged him. I knew they would.
Sun Made Raisins made a comment.
That's why I tagged him.
On his video.
Get him the sour raisins. I will try.
I will.
I'll DM him tonight.
DM him tonight. All right. Thanks.
Give me the address.
Thank you.
Bogdana, mini educator is the only way to go. I paid $190 and it was the best money I ever spent.
Yeah. Good for you, Bogdana.
Corinne says, enjoy Father's Day tomorrow.
Thank you so much. I will.
Unique, do you guys come to California anytime, like Sacramento?
I'm going
to
be in San Francisco. Guys.
Isn't that close?
Yeah, San Francisco is coming up in 2 weeks. I only have audit spots. Working spots have been sold out for 2 months. 2 months minimum they've been sold out. They sold out almost instantly. I will be back in San Francisco. As soon as I finish the San Francisco seminar, which is over on Sunday night, I will announce the next San Francisco seminar. And I might do it relatively quickly. Because that one sold out.
Yeah, it did.
Like, that one sold out quick. We will do one.
Sold out twice.
Yes. So, but there's audit spots. You will learn a ton from audit. Also, on Monday, you can do private. So, this is what I'm suggesting you do. You do audit. Do the audit. 2 days with you. Monday, book a private with your dog if you feel. If you just go to the Monday one, it's not because I want you to spend the money on, like, you know, the ticket there. You will lose so much. You will learn so much from 19 hours of content. Next.
Put my jug away. Kyle, my friend has a 10-month-old Doberman puppy who has started acting aggressively towards some dogs that he does and doesn't know.
Yep.
Barks, lunges at this.
Yep.
In the past, he has always been fine.
Yep. That's normal. It's not acceptable, but it's normal. Now it's time for that Doberman to learn what no means. Next.
Tim, what is a GSD?
GSD, Tim, is a German Shepherd dog. It's a standard abbreviation that they use for German Shepherds. It's a German Shepherd dog, GSD. Next.
He said thanks.
Oh, you're welcome.
Vegan Power Couple gave you 2 thumbs up.
Oh, Vegan Power, did they comment it yet?
I don't think so.
Yeah, hey, what's up? Love
Julie.
You guys.
Thanks for all you do. Yes, it's the one-year-old starting the fetch fight, and it gets even more aggressive when held back on a leash. We'll do muzzle.
Okay, it's aggressive when held back. That's just the drive. Bonk it, okay? So you're holding the dog back. This is a great – who's that, Judy? Julie? Julie, it's a great training opportunity. You ready? Dog's on a leash. It's getting all worked up. This is what I want you to do. Put the dog on a leash. Before the ball even gets thrown or the stick even gets thrown or whatever they're fetching, that dog starts to get all worked up. Starts to. No, bonk. Okay? Telling you, it is a game changer. That's how you stop arousal. Next.
Top chat, $5. Brandy, my dog squeezes his big butt under the bed.
Don't be shaming. Yo, okay?
Don't be shaming big butts.
Don't be shaming big butts.
And then he whines. Any reason? Should I be worried he'll stay under there until we force him out? Interesting.
Okay. Tell you that fat ass dog to get his fat ass.
Hey, don't be shaming big booties.
Okay. I'm not. Okay. Tell that fat ass dog. Okay. To get its fat ass out from under the bed. Okay. So keep a leash on the dog. Get it out from under the bed. Teach it place instead. If it needs a place to go lay down. Next.
Vegan Power Couple, y'all are the best. Love you guys. Thanks for all your help. My 7-month-old Pitbull Chihuahua GSD mix. Loves you guys.
Thanks, Vegan Power Couple. I'm going to imagine that you're vegan, right? Have you seen my rant on vegan dog food? Mm. Have you seen that yet? If you have, and you're still watching, thank you, because you get it. Because you get it.
If you haven't.
If you haven't.
Don't watch it. Maybe.
You might not want to come
back. She just never comes back. Like, it's the last time she's on the show.
You might not come back. I went off. I went off.
It's on the feed somewhere.
It's on the feed somewhere. Some guy's girlfriend who is vegan, and it's not a vegan.
What are you going to feed it?
Why did the feeder die? A vegan diet.
Next. Marnie, cool dog. Hey, guys. Happy Father's Day. See y'all in Cali.
Thanks. Thanks, Marnie.
Blue on black. Thanks for responding to the comment about seatbelt harness. You said the dog should be trained in and down briefly, but I think it would be great if you do a video covering dog restraints in cars. Thanks.
I don't do a video. You know what? That's not my level of expertise. I don't restrain my dogs. So I've got an SUV. I've always had SUVs or vans. My dogs, my personal dogs are in the rear of the SUV, and I've got actually a baby gate between the second row and the back. And I know if I get into a really bad car accident, I know that I'm fucked. I know I'm fucked. I just do. And I'm okay with that. The other only other option in a seatbelt harness system is not necessarily the answer, by the way. It's not necessarily the answer for safety. They do make, I think, one or two crash test crates that you can put your dogs in. Next.
Unique says, what's the website to buy an e-collar? Melissa posted it.
You can go right to mine. You know, if you want to save $20 or $10 to $20, go to Amazon. But or if you want to just go onto our website, solidcaninetraining.com, buy a website from us. You know, I think we make $35 profit on them. So feel free. Next.
Kinsey, when working with resource guarders, is it adventurous to teach tug? If so, how would you safely go about it when strong?
Yeah, I do it.
Out? And how does it differ from teaching a non-resource guarder?
Because tug isn't resource guarding. Tug is controlled biting. There's a humongous difference between controlled biting and uncontrolled biting. Wanted biting and unwanted biting. There is a huge, huge, huge difference. So, and you teach out. Big difference. Next.
Unique, whenever I try to put my dog's muzzle on, he gets very aggressive. How do I prevent that?
Do we have a proper muzzle training video?
Probably.
Did we make a video of that in the last seminar?
Uh-huh.
But I admit it hasn't been edited yet, though, right?
Yeah, I posted that.
Did you? Oh.
It was from, like, Wisconsin. It was long.
There's another one we just did, I think, recently. One of the recent seminars. Collingwood.
But it wasn't as good as the one you did in
Wisconsin.
I probably didn't even bother filming it because I already put that really good one out.
Yeah. But muzzle train the dog. Next.
Julie, love the bonk. Never thought of it with fetch. Duh, Julie.
Joel, don't worry about it, Julie. Next.
Crystal, hi, Jeff and Joelle. When using e-collar on working levels, my Great Dane starts scratching at it. Feels like she might be blowing me off. Is this common? Any suggestions?
Yeah, that's like, hey, it's dinner time. Okay, I'll be right down as they finish watching the last 5 minutes of their show or talking to their friends. Back in the day, we unhooked the telephone. Now, I wish I can smash their screens, but I can't because I'm going to have to fucking pay them.
Yeah, exactly.
So, all right. So I can't turn off the Wi-Fi because they're using their data. So next.
Ah, today's kids, I tell you. Melissa posted the link to shop the t-shirts.
Nice. Thank you, Melissa.
Vegan Power Couple says, haha, I have. I agree with you. You're the best. Thank you. Wow.
Thank you. Kudos. That's one smart vegan.
Crystal.
It's a no, it is. It's a person that fucking just is like, okay, fine.
Yeah.
It's okay. I know. It's okay.
Crystal, by the way, thanks for the great Skype. Awesome information.
You're welcome, Crystal. Thank you for trusting me with your money. Next.
Stephanie, my dog falls asleep during
place?
During stays on place.
Yep.
A bed. Fine. Any other tips on teaching a dog to be calm?
Place and down is like the best. Place and down. It's the best. I mean, pretty much your dog should be down all the time. Girl's in pain. She's going for surgery.
No.
Yeah.
She's not comfortable.
Yeah, I know. Next.
Catherine, I'm vegan too and saw the rant. I laughed. Still a fan.
Great. Thank you.
Danielle, Vario kennels are crash tested. That's what I use.
Got it. Awesome. Thank you. Vario. There you go.
Hi, Roberto. Hi, guys. Happy Father's Day, Jeff.
Oh, thanks.
Jeff, what is the best time to start e-collar training? Is there any main first step? Thank you. God bless both.
Yeah. What I do is this. I think anything moving away or coming to you. So believe it or not, recall and or place. I like place as the first thing. I like an in-movement thing for teaching remote collar to start next.
Sasha, I have an issue. I feel people bully my dog. I tell them no, but they try. Everything keeps bumping me. I'm so sorry, guys. They try to harass my dog. Okay. I don't like the neighbor's dog off leash. It upsets me.
Okay. So you commented on YouTube and I responded to this. What I pretty much said this, would you allow somebody to come up and touch your boobs? I believe you're a female. I saw your profile picture in YouTube. Would you allow somebody to come up and touch your boobs? Would you allow somebody to, if you had an outdoor shed, just come on your property, open up your outdoor shed and take your lawnmower? Would you allow somebody to open up your passenger door and sit in your car, just in a traffic spot? Would you allow somebody to just walk in your house and take your TV? No, you wouldn't. What would you do? Would you be polite with them? Would you reason with them? Or would you say to them, get the fuck out of here or I will shoot you dead where you stand? Now, you don't have to do that, but your tone should be very similar to that. So, do you mind if I pet your dog? Can I pet your dog? Can we pet your dog? Thank you for asking. No, you cannot. The discussion is over. Thank you for asking. No, you could not. That is if you are asked. Okay? I'm always polite. I am polite all the time. Like all the time. Like if you hung out, you'd be like, wow, he's a really polite guy. Okay? So what I want you to do now, if it goes past that, now all bets are off. Okay? Now we go into go fuck yourself. I was polite. I did what society says, not only society, but the way I was raised. But now we step up a notch. And we don't step it up a little. I'm going all the way. Why? Because you're an entitled human being and you don't know a little. So I need to squash. Okay? I need to overpower you with incredible amount of force with my words. And I have to mean it. So I was kind to you. You persisted. And now it's move the fuck away from my dog right now or I will move you. Oh my God, you're so fucking violent, da 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 da. At least 3 times a week, I'm getting calls from people who are actually being attacked for saying no, that you can't pet your dog. Literally, I tell you, you can't pet my dog, and all of a sudden, you're getting attacked. Women are being called a bitch. They're being called the C word. It's like, and guess who's doing a lot of this? Other women. The women on women aggression in the dog industry, the dog field, is out of control. It's really bad. It's horrific. Next.
Kinsey, that makes so much sense. Thanks.
Yep.
Sandy. Colleen, hi Jeff, Linda, and Joelle. Love the vid on haters. All those keyboard warriors behind their keyboards.
Yeah, I love haters. I really do. They make me so much money. I smile. I get hate every day and I fucking laugh. I pee. I'm giddy. Oh shit, hour 32. Sorry. Hey guys, the show. One more question and the show is over.
Nadia, hi guys. I have a 1.5-year-old black lab Doberman who has separation anxiety. We've done training, but he still whines while in the crate when we leave. What can I do?
Okay. I don't know what kind of training you've done. So we've got very specific training for separation anxiety. Start out by watching it, go on to my YouTube channel, which you're on now. Watch my separation anxiety video. And then also there's going to be a lot of remote collar work in that. All right. JeffGellmanSeminars.com, SolidCanineTraining.com. How about this? For all my replay folks, for everybody watching my replay, okay. What I want you to do, welcome and thank you for being there. Comment below. A couple of people asked about dog parks. comment below why you think dog parks are bad or why you think they're good. All right, comment below. All right, I love all you guys. Take care. I feel honored and blessed to have you as an audience. And thank you so much.
Bye. Good night.